We've all seen those huge metal boxes on top of retail stores or warehouses. In this video, we'll explain what they are, how they work, and why they're called RTUs. An RTU, or rooftop unit, is one of the most simple and common pieces of commercial equipment around. Now, while the name suggests it, RTUs don't necessarily have to be installed on a rooftop, though the location does offer several benefits. First, being on the roof saves space around the building and utilizes the space that would otherwise go unused. This also makes it easier to add to the system if needed. Second, being elevated, the RTU stays cleaner with less exposure to things like dust, dirt, or grass clippings. Third, the unit is less accessible, so the odds of theft, tampering, or accidental damage are reduced. And lastly, when cooling a space, the system doesn't have to work as hard since cooler air naturally flows downward. So how does a rooftop unit work? First and foremost, the primary purpose of the RTU is to cool air and provide that air to the building ductwork for distribution. It does this by cycling a refrigerant with a very low boiling point through its components. RTUs are also known as packaged units because they contain these components in a single cabinet, things like a condenser, compressor, evaporator coil, and a fan. Here's how it all works. A couple of fans kick on, one to begin moving the air through the condenser, and the other to begin moving air through the system ducts. Inside air enters the RTU and runs through the filters to trap contaminants. This incoming air is likely a mix of outside air and return air, which has already been moved through the space. This mix helps maintain indoor air quality. The air then passes through an evaporator coil. The evaporator coil has cold liquid refrigerant running through it. As the air moves through the coil and refrigerant absorb the heat in the air, and the air becomes cooler. The fan then blows the newly conditioned air into the system, where it is distributed throughout the zone. The heated refrigerant, which is vapor at this point, then flows into another component within the packaged unit, the compressor. Here, it is compressed to a higher pressure and heated. Outside, this vapor then moves through another component, the condenser coil, where the condenser fan blows outdoor air through the coil and back out the unit. This outside air cools the refrigerant down to a liquid, making it ready to have its pressure significantly reduced, thus cooling it and making it ready again for the evaporator coil. This process runs continuously until the space reaches the desired temperature. And have you ever heard of a single stage, two stage, or three stage rooftop unit? This is typically referring to the number of settings which width the compressor can run, so off, low, medium, or high. The more stages, the more control one has on the refrigerant, temperature, and air volume moving through the unit, increasing the energy efficiency of the RTU. In northern climates, RTU systems will typically include a heating element to move warm air through the ducts when needed. RTUs can also include an economizer, which pulls in outside air when the temperature and humidity are right, allowing the building to cool efficiently without the expense of running the compressor. So what are we doing talking about RTUs? Well, at KMC Controls, we manufacture a number of products that directly control rooftop units. Whether our customizable FlexStat room controller, our application-specific RTU version of our AppStat room controller, or our KMC Conquest unitary controller. In short, we've got the products you need to get the job done in nearly any application. And to learn more about these or any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, please check out our other videos or visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.